announcements after the arrival of thousands of British troops, here's then Prime Minister Tony Blair.
Literally, we have destroyed virtually all the terrorist training camps of Al-Qaeda. We've destroyed an enormous amount of the military infrastructure of the Taliban. Their air power is, so far as it exists, is completely taken out.
Unfortunately, though, the numbers of people dying continue to rise. In 2009, the most deadly year, 108 troops were killed. The Taliban, which continues to fight, has carried out attacks in recent weeks.
I got back from Afghanistan in August this year, and I was gunning for the RSM.
Sam Castledine, who's 24, is from County Durham. He's a rifleman who's just got back from a three-month tour of the country.
When you go back into Boston, you do see the big memorial of, you know, all the soldiers lost, and you do have a lot of time to reflect on, you know, this is the fallen. Obviously, you know, I was fortunate that nothing happened to any of my you know, friends and colleagues on this tour.
Overall, 140,000 UK troops have served in Afghanistan at an operational cost of over £19 billion. 500 mentors from the military will stay to help Afghan forces keep control. It's an area Sam still has concern about.
Yeah, we worked alongside them closely on a number of operations.